Shigem approaches the monitor, the last remaining beast in the room. He turns with affection to look at his creator. "You've been a bit ignored, haven't you, sitting over there?" he asks, and Jaymi nods. "Oh well," continues Shigem, "I'll leave you with this, in case it helps. Whenever life gets a bit much and I'm in danger of coming over all unnecessary, I just think of pineapple upside-down cake. As soon as I think about it, all is well with the world. I mean, isn't it the coolest, how it tells you all about itself in its actual name? And how adorably sweet and lovely, back in those caveman days or whenever it was, that while everyone else from the cave was out somewhere killing other people from other caves, there was one little queen like me who decided it was so much more important to stay back home alone in the cave and invent pineapple upside-down cake instead. I know just why she did that." He climbs gracefully up to the monitor, grabs its edges with a flourish of strength that causes his bangles to jangle in the quiet of the study, and glances back at his maker one last time. "I'd also like to point out that when it comes to fruitcakes, being heavily fruited is not the same thing as being overfruited. Bye-bye, Jaymi." Shigem's warm brown eyes flash the most beautiful smile his creator has ever seen, and perhaps will ever see. Then he's gone, like his companions before him, all sealed into their allotted games forever, never again to run wild through the danger and mess of meat space.